Evening, caller. This is Forrest Nash, host of 189.16, The Scream, and tonight's 911 stand-in.
Hi! Hello? Am I on air?
Sure are, caller. What's your name, and what have you got for us tonight?
Name's Eugene Stein, and I've got a heart full of love, Forrest. I'm hanging out in the middle of the maze, listening to your show, looking up at the stars and waiting for her.
You got a special lady coming out to see you.
Yeah. Molly. We planned to get lost in the maze tonight. To take our first journey together into the love labyrinth. That's why I'm calling, actually. I thought she'd be here an hour ago. And since I've listened all night to how cool you play it, I thought you were the perfect guy to ask. Should I call her up and ask if she's coming, or wait and see?
For real, kid?
If you've been listening all night, do you really need to ask me?
Yes, that's why I'm calling.
Eugene, you really need to go home to your parents.
My parents are dead, actually. But,
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, I guess it's not the night. Hang on! I hear some rustling. I guess she came after all. Molly! I'm in the middle! It'll take a little while to get here, but, thanks again, Forrest. It's been good talking. Oh, wait a second. Molly can't whistle. No, no! This is supposed to be the best night of my life! Not the worst!
Stay calm, Eugene. We'll get you out of this.
Carl! I'm about to die a virgin!
Listen, Eugene. Breathe, hide, and call back in a minute. We'll get you out.
I'll do it for Molly. But please, hurry!
Well, listeners, while Peggy and I deliberate, here's a track for all you lovers out there. How the hell am I supposed to get him through the maze?
You know Barbara, our receptionist? She's a maze fanatic. Shame she isn't here. I was supposed to go with her last week, but she changed her mind.
Why'd she change her mind?
She went with that jerk Brad instead.
I'm so sorry to hear that, Peggy.
It's fine. I'm not the one who had to go out with that jerk Brad, after all.
Maybe we should call Barbara then, if she's so big on the maze.
We could, but I don't actually know her number. But she probably has maze stuff somewhere. Go and see what you can find. That'll hopefully be enough.
Which one is Barbara again?
Barbara! You know, Barbara!
Forrest,
I've seen you speak to her.
Help me out, Peggy.
She's the receptionist. Sits at reception. Never does any work because she's talking to Brad all day? Ring any bells?
Right, yeah. Sorry, I guess it's just the stress of...
No excuses. Just go and find something to help us.
Looks like Brad broke her heart. Wonder what she'd have done with all that maze stuff. Bingo, here's what I was looking for.
Any luck?
For Eugene, yes. For Barbara, no. Brad canceled the date, so Barbara left her tickets and a map for the Maze Maze behind.
Ugh, Barbara can do better than... Never mind. Let's save the kid. Eugene called while you were away. He's on line one.
Welcome back to 189.16, The Scream. I hope you lovers like that track. And I hope we can help our lover in the Maze Maze. Eugene, you're back on air.
I'm lost, Forrest. I just ran and I don't know where I am. I'm at a crossroad, facing a tractor statue. There are hay bales painted gold on my right.
Go left.
Okay. I went left, then tried a right. I have a pig statue in front of me and a creepy rocking horse on my left.
Go backwards.
Oh, God! Why didn't I just fight her over? I'm at a crossroads. There's a pitchfork statue up ahead. Which way?
Go left. Go right.
I can't run much more. I just passed a corn silo. Didn't see anything else. Please, where do I go?
Go right.
I'm out. And my bike's still here. Oh, thank you, Forrest. I love you, Molly.
That was tense. I think I held my breath the whole time.
I think it went pretty well, Oldhold.
I think you're right.
By the way, why do you think Molly missed their date? Do you think she's okay?
Unfortunately for Eugene, I think she probably never left home.
Thank you for calling in, Mr. Walton. We'll make sure to add the town librarian to our list of suspicious Clives.
Remember, report a Clive to stay alive. Next caller is up, Forrest, so take it away.
Caller, you're through to Forrest Nash on 189.16, The Scream.
Hey, wonderful show tonight, Forrest.
Well, that's kind of you to say. Thank you. What's your name, caller?
You can call me Dawn. Could you play my tune, Forrest?
Your tune? Sure.
Long Ride Home.
That old song. Sure, we got it. I think I played it the other day.
Thanks. It'll be good to hear it again.
All right, folks. Coming up is that old classic.
Forrest, I don't think you're gonna find that song.
What do you mean? I played it a few nights ago.
I know, but... we don't have it anymore.
What are you talking about?
I threw it away.
You threw it in the trash?
No, I threw it out the window earlier today.
And why did you throw it out the window earlier today?
Brad was annoying me all afternoon. He played it on repeat because he knows I don't like it. So I grabbed it and threw it right out of one of the office windows. Not my finest hour, but I can only take so much.
All right. So, what do we do instead then?
Let's just play a different song. We've got more important things to think about anyway.
Gotcha. Okay, folks. Here comes some unrequested music. Sorry about that, Dawn. Maybe try again tomorrow night.
Sorry.
It's funky, it's groovy, it's Stab in the Twilight by Knife and Easy.
Of all the songs to request, why'd it have to be that one?
Gee, Peggy, what did the Barn Finds ever do to you?
Wrote that song, for one. It gets real old when you're forced to listen to it on repeat for years.
Why couldn't they just request Roddy?
Oh, Forrest, scrap the song. We have another caller.
Sorry to cut the music short, folks. Callers take priority tonight. Welcome to 189.16 The Scream. This is Forrest Nat.
Forrest? Oh, thank God. It's me again. Murphy?
Hey, how'd it go, Mr. Dojo?
Oh, the killer got me, man. Why did I ever trust a guy named Master Robin?
I warned you not to.
Hindsight is 20/20, okay?
Forrest, we need to do something.
Goddamn piece of... He came to the Gallows Waste Disposal Plant. Beat on me, man. Carry me inside and lock me in a dumpster. I got a flashlight, but... Oh, goddamn. I smell smoke. I think he started a fire.
Hold on, Murphy. We'll call for help right now.
You gotta hurry, man. I need someone here now or I'm gonna die.
Peggy, get the fire department on the line.
On it. All right. Now just... Come on, pick up. Hi. Yes, I'd like to report a fire over at the Gallows Waste Disposal Plant. It's an emergency. What do you mean it's not operational? Why is there no backup vehicle? Oh, God damn it! Forrest, that evil son of a bitch slashed the tires on the town's only fire engine. They can't do anything. But I have a few friends who live nearby. Maybe one of them can save Murphy.
Where do they live?
My friend Alex lives on the corner of Haddonfield and Romero Street, and Catherine lives on the west end of Myers Lane. And there's Jericho on the east end of Myers Lane. But he's... old. Really old.
Okay, I'll check the map, see who would be best to do this.
All right, Forrest, who should I call? Who can help Murphy?
Call Catherine.
All right, give me a second. They're on the way. They'll call from the plant. You can direct them from there.
Well, let's hope they get there in time.
Call coming in. It's Catherine. She and Murphy are now both on the line.
Hello, Catherine. Are you there? What's happening at the plant?
The whole damn thing is up in smoke. God damn it. I'm going in. Oh, my reception is terrible in here. God, my eyes sting.
Murphy, can you see anything at all?
Yeah. I got a little flashlight. Looks like old cans, bottles, and newspaper.
What does it say on the newspaper?
It's the Henderson headline.
What was that? My reception is terrible in here. Please, Forrest, tell me where to go.
Go to recycling.
Recycling. Got it.
Come on, Catherine.
Murphy, do you know what part of the plant you're in?
I'm in a dumpster, man! What do you want from me?
Do you hear anything, Murphy?
I hear my heart about to pound out of my chest!
Put the receiver up to the lid.
Good enough!
Catherine, go to the crusher. Open the Henderson container.
The light is really... I found him!
Thank God! Let's haul ass!
It's coming down!
Oh, shit!
Hey, you just get home to your son, okay?
Will do, Forrest.
Well, folks, Gallows Creek has two folk heroes tonight, Murphy and Catherine. I'm sure their deeds won't soon be forgotten.
Great job, Forrest. No time to celebrate, though. We got a caller. You know what to do.
All right, folks. Another of our good citizens is on the line. Let's see what they have to say. Welcome to 189.16 The Scream, with me, your host, Forrest Nash.
Forrest, Teddy Gallows Jr. here. I just want to say that my thoughts and prayers are with my Gallows Creek neighbors during this awful time.
Oh, it's mayoral candidate and scion of the town founders, Mr. Gallows. Are you in danger?
We need to be a town of law and order. We need cops who have the tools and funding they need to keep us safe.
Okay, Teddy.
I know. You're an outsider to our little town here, Forrest. But you're really stepping up to bat for us all tonight. I just want to say thank you for taking a swing for Gallows Creek.
Jackass.
Right. Thanks, Teddy. Now, are you...
Teddy, you lowlife! This is not the time to promote your damn campaign!
I just want to make sure our town is safe and prosperous. That's why the Gallows Family Factory, founded by my father, Theodore C. Gallows, God rest his soul, which employs over 200...
Teddy, unless you've got an emergency, I'm cutting you off.
You know what? I do have a problem. A problem that's ruining our town. Do you know what it is?
I didn't ask about a problem. I said emergency.
The problem is that woman, our current mayor, Linda Cartwright.
Oh, here we go.
She just isn't one of us. Linda Cartwright is un-American, unstable, and...
You're not better than anyone, Teddy. Just because you inherited half the town, it...
Your producer sounds a little unstable, too.
Don't you dare speak to me that way.
Cut him off, Peggy.
I can guarantee this kind of thing will not happen when I take office. The moral decay of...
And that's enough of Teddy Gallows Jr. for one lifetime.
I always feel disgusting after hearing him talk.
Just play an ad for us. I need a minute.
We'll be right back after these messages.
The world famous annual Gallows Creek Harvest Festival is back! We got it all out on Giblet Field. We got the Little Miss Harvest Pageant, Princess Harvest Pageant, Harvest Queen Pageant, Cotton Candy, Corn Dogs, Cornhole, Corn on the Cob, Crokinole, Country Music, Can Jam, Jams, Jellies, Jamborees, Juggling, Roller Rickies, Roller Disco Lessons, Praying. We got baby crawling, balloon popping, balloons for sale, beard contest, horseshoes, hayride, hay toss, hey you there, safe donkeys and ponies, apple bobbing, firearm, fireworks, funnel cakes, fried dough, sheets, bitten, sand licking, cracker cramming, and cat shop. And fake tattoo, face painting, puppets, petting zoo, amazing maze, square dancing, story swapping, spelling bee, quilting bee, and sewing circle, pie eating, lawnmower racing, hot dog eating, flower contest, and of course our famous gourd measure-off. The festival is brought to you by Mayor Linda Cartwright, sponsored by Gallows & Sons Factory, and dedicated to the memory of Garrett Miley, tragically taken from us last festival.
I can see why it's world famous.
It's a highlight around here, Forrest.
Oh, I am sorry to hear that, Peggy. All right, folks, welcome back to the show. We have a note from my producer.
That's right. Come find me at the Harvest Festival tomorrow to grab your choice of a KFAM mug, sticker set, or poster.
Let's see what our next caller would choose.
Caller on line one.
Hello, caller. You're live on The Scream with me, Forrest Nash. Hello? Caller?
Who is this? I need the police.
I'm Forrest Nash. I'm standing in for 911 tonight. What's wrong?
There's a guy hunting me and my friends. I think he's killed some of them already. That's him. He's just outside. I can see him from up here.
God damn it. She's just a kid.
Is there a way out? Can you run?
Oh my God, oh my God.
Stay with me, kid. Focus.
I can't do this.
Yes, you can. Focus. Tell me, what's your name?
Sweetie, you can do it. What's your name?
Carrie.
Good, good. Carrie, listen to me. We're gonna get you out of there, all right? Now, where are you?
The old murder house. Upstairs. I'm at the end of a hall. There's a bathroom, a couple bedrooms, a closet. Oh, he's coming. Where should I go?
Go to the closet.
Okay, I'll...
Don't move! Okay, what the hell is going on here?
Oh, who's on the phone, Carrie? The cops? It's just a joke, jeez.
Wait, isn't that...
Jimmy, that wasn't funny, you sicko! Of course I called the cops, but some guy just answered instead.
What guy?
Forrest Nash. What the hell are you all doing?
It's prank night, old man. We're just having fun.
That's the kid. The kid who called in earlier pretending to be the whistling man.
That's it. I'm out of here.
Jimmy, this is a pretty sick thing to do.
What? It's whistling night.
That little idiot.
Whistling night?
It's a stupid tradition. Especially stupid since that one kid died back in... Would you take off that stupid mask if it's hard to breathe? Who's under there anyway? Is that you? Seth.
Idiot! Seth is right next to you. That's, wait.
Oh, no.
Who are you?
Oh, no, man!
Everyone, get inside!
Oh, holy shit.
You two, barricade the door. Scott, Heather, you barricade the back. As long as he's out there, safe, right?
You bought time, but not much.
Forrest, we have to...
Heather, I already called the cops. Forrest picked up. He's the best we're gonna get.
Who is with you, Carrie?
My friend. We drove out to the old murder house, and... Of course! The van! Who's got the keys? Jimmy had them. Jimmy.
Okay. It's gonna be okay, Carrie.
Right.
We'll figure something out. Between all of you, there's gotta be a way to beat this. Just sit tight, okay?
Heather, shut up. If we do that, we're gonna get killed. If only Jeannie were here.
Jeannie? Jeannie McPherson? Our intern Jeannie?
Yes. She's my best friend and the smartest one out of all of us. She stayed in tonight. Forrest, listen. We'll see what we can come up with, and, what? Scott, you're not any good at... And... No, Chad. Out of all of us, you're not the one to...
Everything okay?
No. We're figuring out a plan, but everyone's volunteering to do things they're just bad at. I think we can figure out what to do, but I don't think we can agree on who should do what. I think you'll have to be the tiebreaker. Or else these idiots are gonna get us killed.
But I...
Shut up, you... Ugh. Forrest, I'll call you back.
But I don't know anything about your friends.
Ugh. These damn kids never learn.
Breathe, Peggy. It's okay.
Ugh. They do this kind of thing every year, Forrest. People get hurt.
All right, folks, we're going to work out a way to save Carrie and her friends. This next one goes out to all the trapped kids out there. Peggy, you mentioned something about their friend working here? An intern?
Yeah, Jeannie. Seems a nice enough girl, but a bit head in the clouds, you know? Not sure why we took on an intern. We really didn't have the office space for one. Poor thing got tucked away in a dark corner somewhere downstairs, I heard.
All right. I'll go see if I can find her desk. Hopefully she has something we can use. Jeez, they really tucked Jeannie away. Friendship quiz. This might work.
You find anything that'll help us out?
Yeah, I found a friendship quiz with all these kids on it.
If you think that'll help, then good enough. Carrie's on line one, whenever you're ready.
This is Forrest Nash, back again with an unlucky caller on this unlucky night. Carrie, are you there?
Yes, we've got a plan, but we can't agree on who should do what.
You want me to be the tiebreaker?
Exactly.
I'm ready. What's the first step?
Okay. First things first, we'll need a spotter. Someone who can keep an eye on the killer. We'll need someone on the roof. It's gonna be a hard climb. We're deciding between Heather, Kyle, and Hot David.
Heather's got this.
Yes, Heather. He picked you. Now please, stop talking about all your cheerleading trophies. Part two. The whistling man padlocked the gate back to the road. Before we drive out of here, we need someone to pick the lock. Seth, Jennifer, and Scott all want to do it.
Jennifer.
Jesus, Jennifer, you carry a bump key? Why didn't you say so earlier? Anyway, that brings us to part three. Getting the van keys. I'll volunteer for this. I don't know Jimmy as well as you guys, so... it'll probably be easier that way. Then is part four.
This is a very detailed plan. I'm impressed.
Yeah, it's weirdly easier to think when you're about to die.
You're doing great. What's the next part?
Part four. We need someone to lead the whistling man away. We need a fast runner. For this one, we're trying to decide between... who was it again? Hot David, Cynthia, and Scott.
Hot David.
Yeah, you, do spend a lot of time running shirtless. You got this, Hot David. Sweet. Okay, let's recap. We get the eyes on the roof. A runner distracts the killer while we grab the van keys and pick the lock on the gate. Now the tricky part. The getaway.
Ooh, what's the plan there?
Well, we can't all outrun the whistling man. But he thinks we're just a bunch of stupid teens. So... that against him. Part five. We trick the killer into a trap. Someone can pretend to be injured. Who would make the most believable bait?
Who you got?
We got Lisa, Tammy, and Cynthia.
Lisa.
Whoa.
You're right, Lisa. Having to smile at rude customers is perfect practice. That should take care of the killer. And then it's time to get out of here. Finally, part six. We need someone who can drive us through the woods and back to Gallows Creek alive. Who's our getaway driver? Should it be... who have we got? Chad? Scott? Cynthia? Ugh, whatever. Forrest, you know what to do.
Chad.
Oh, perfect. Your go-karting experience will be great, Chad.
Thanks, Forrest. We'll just take a few seconds for ourselves, and then it's go time.
Sounds good. Talk to you in a sec.
Good luck, Carrie. That actually sounded like a pretty good plan.
Impressive as hell, right?
Damn straight. Oh, the kids are back already. Line one again.
If you're just tuning in, we're coming to you live with a bunch of teens about to flee a madman. Listener discretion is advised. Are you ready, Carrie?
We're good to go, Forrest.
Good luck. And Godspeed.
You got this.
Here we go, everyone. Swatter, to the roof. Go, Heather. She's off and away. All right, Brenner. Get ready. Wait for the spotter's signal. Spotter says go.
Keys, Carrie. You need to get the van keys.
His face is lying next to him, Forrest. He got cut. Oh, God.
Focus. Breathe.
Right. The van keys. Got him. Jennifer got the gate unlocked. And Hot David should be back any second. Perfect. It's working. I can't believe it's actually working.
You're doing great.
Focus. You got this.
We got this. Next step, trap the killer. All right. Bait. Get into position. Everybody else, hide. Okay, performer. Now, act like your life depends on it.
What was that?
It's a whistling man! Drive! Now! Let me go! Just go! Just drive!
Oh my God.
You're okay.
Can you get somewhere safe?
Yeah. I can make it home. Thank you both for helping. If you hadn't, I...
It was your plan, Carrie, and it was a great plan.
It was really all you, Carrie.
Still, I need to get home.
Breathe, Carrie. You're okay now.
I'll call you when I'm somewhere safe. Talk to you then.
Folks, that was a lot. Our thoughts go out to Jimmy's parents in this awful time. For any kids listening in, please stay inside and stay safe.
And parents, hug your kids extra tight tonight.
Here's a song for the girl walking home in the dark.
Hey, we had a call come in.